Saying goodbye to the ordeal.
You traffic slaves illegally. You killed people in futile property quarrels.
I've changed.
Into what? At the point, you have my bodyguard. This guy is ambitious. I'm not sure I trust him.
Oof. Which means that Eric is gonna die because Kane is gonna kill him.
We saw no signs of other humans. No animal or wildlife believe that the prospects and the weather here will improve very soon, no?
Then we should try and settle this empty land, this land.
Oh, I really have the impression that we heard all of that before.
So I suggest that our next move be to parcel up the land equally and fairly between all of the families.
We cannot farm.
There will be hardships for sure. We are the people, are we not?
You're making
sense. That we call it green light. How will we attract them, settlers, huh?
It's Groenland? Greenland?
This is not the land that you saw. No.
What is your plan, Ube? You want to continue to search, maybe? You're not gonna kill him in front of everyone.
What do you want? I don't do his words, and he doesn't trust you. So let's kill him. And crown you instead.
You're a man of few words, really. It's not a test, I don't think so. I don't think that he is that clever. Can it be possible? Do I want that? It doesn't seem right. Harald or Eric. Say stuff like that. I understand that. I hate that. That's part of the plan of Eric, maybe? Are you gonna believe that? And Eric. Okay, part of your plan.
Long live the king.
I didn't expect that at all. An Harald nightmare. He was preparing himself to die. That's it, you found your bodyguard.
I crown you king of Kattegat and of all Norway.
No. I said during the intro that he was gonna sit on that throne on my dead body. But I said also that if he will go on the throne during this episode, he's gonna leave it next one.
It is my intention to marry the beautiful, the beloved, Gunhild. But it is also my intention to marry the woman called Ingrid, who will also be my queen.
Your dream was to be Björn. Since the beginning, you wanted to be him, to have everything that he had.
No one in this world has ever done for me what you have done for me. I'm aware of you now. You have to understand that I was your friend because I needed you to help me escape from your uncle. But still, no one has ever cared for me the way you have cared for me.
I think so. I think that you truly loved the kid.
I was a cripple too. I was silly. Damaged. I wanted to die. You saved me.
Oh.
You have been everything to me. I love you. I always will.
That's sweet. And I really hope that everyone's feelings right there are right. And I'm gonna stay like that.
Are you absolutely certain that you are carrying Prince John?
I think so.
No. Of course not.
Oh!
Can you possibly contemplate marrying King Harald after what he did to you? You know perfectly well why.
To stay alive?
I'm not a shield maiden like you, or lack of them. I have no advantages, except for using my wits and my sex.
I'm sorry for you.
Can you blame me?
This is not Björn's kid, maybe? So he really lost all of his descendants? Yeah? Telling you to continue your journey, to not stay there.
We should leave this place. If you can, he who was living is now dead. We who were living are now dying. Ragna? Do you mean Ragna?
You're gonna talk with...
All of us, we are dying. Don't you see, son of Ragna? Are you as blind as all the rest?
I believe this, sir. Yeah.
My heart. My husband. I want to pressure to marry King Harald. This is the only way to retain my status. If I do not marry him, then I have nothing.
No, that's not right. You showed me that.
The time of great heroes is over.
You were Björn's wife.
We lost Ragnar. We lost Lagnar.
I'm not gonna cry today. Stop.
I lost you.
Stop!
Perhaps the golden age of the Vikings is gone.
I can't believe that. I don't want to believe that.
I will not compromise myself. I will not compromise you. I will do the right thing.
It's better not be killing yourself. I'm afraid. What is it? You saw something or someone? It's on the land, right? No, that's the ocean. Oh. Huh?
As you can see, the whale has washed up on my property. Look for yourselves, it's true. It's our whale. You don't need the whole animal.
Okay, you're thinking about food? Food and fuel, okay?
The whale belongs to me. If anyone can prove otherwise, let them say so.
We're really gonna do that? Fight for that whale?
I thought we were all in this together, no? The gods, they make their decisions. The gods decide.
Trust you?
There has to be some reason.
It's called luck.
There's no such thing.
Oh, I'm sorry for the light I didn't see. What weird episode was that? That was a slower one. Again, you know, like the episode 12 was, which is great, you know. I really have the impression that we're gonna have one episode someone is killed, one episode a break. One episode someone is killed, one episode being a break. That was our break episode. If we're taking things like that, Ivar and Fitzhugh, they managed to escape the place with Igor and Katya. Igor is now safe with his uncle dear. Everyone is accepting him and all seems alright right there. I'm really glad. Ivar said I love you to Katya, whoever you were. Why not? I'm not against it. Like, she proved us that we can trust her, even if I don't understand her development during this season. She proved it. Ivar and Igor, they had this sweet moment, you know, with the two of them seeing that they care for each other. That was great. And I really hope that nothing is gonna ruin that relationship, you know, that it's gonna stay like that. We didn't have a lot of Fitzhugh during this episode, but for me, after during the episode 13, reminding to the viewers that they don't have a good and healthy relationship since the beginning, that they have a dark background, that we have to remind that maybe I'm gonna use that again during the season, we are not over with that. We're gonna have that again during the next episode, maybe. We have Oleg who is losing his mind and who thinks for a good reason that everyone is betraying him. I mean, I hate the guy, I hate his reasons, I hate his actions, and I want him to die. I think that he's cruel and that he can be also a psychopath, you know. But if you are thinking of the things, you know, from his side, from his point of view, yes, people betrayed him. Yes, people didn't want him to have the place that he thinks that he deserves. So of course he's losing his mind like that. But he has still a lot of dreams and hopes about killing deer, attacking and attacking again, and Igor still being on his side, still being on his side. That he can still control the kid and take him with him. I don't think so. I think that Oleg is gonna fail. I can't see a way for him to win. And even more if he's losing his mind. We'll see. Maybe he's gonna have allies, important allies for these attacks. We have Gunnhild, you know, the situation with Gunnhild. Harald is on the throne. He has the two former wives of Bjorn. Really, he just wanted to be Bjorn Harald. To have the throne, to have this power, to have the two wives, but also to have the image of Bjorn. That's not the good word. You know, Bjorn is a legend, Bjorn is an hero, and Harald, he wants to be remembered as Bjorn is remembered, you know. He wants to have that role, you know, people thinking like that about him. But you can't claim that, you have to work for that, you know, to do stuff for having that. You can't claim it. Eric decided to be his bodyguard, so Eric didn't want to be king. Gunnhild or Ingrid, because she said that she had Bjorn's child, everything was maybe okay for Eric. That's why he didn't choose between the two of them, because he was just doing that for Bjorn. Maybe after this decision that he just took of killing Skaan and not being the king, you know, and choosing that side, I'm thinking like that. I'm glad that Skaan is dead, because really he was dangerous, a real threat, but he was also annoying. So I'm glad that we are already over with him. He was a good character, you know, he was almost funny, but funny like he was so... I don't know how to describe him. He was a threat, he was a man of few words, but in a way that was fun. But again, I'm glad that we are over with him. I get, you know, why Ingrid is gonna accept to marry Harald, who raped her. So maybe Harald is the father of a kid, you know? It's making me sad, not because of the fact that she lied, I can understand why, but because of the fact that it really means that Bjorn doesn't have any descendants. It's so sad. But I get, you know, why she's accepting. Like she said to Gunnhild, she's no one, she's not a child maiden, she doesn't have that image that Gunnhild had. She's the second wife. She needs to marry Harald to survive, just to survive. And I'm not sure that Harald would accept her to not accept, you know, to marry him. Even more if now he thinks that she's carrying his kid. And Gunnhild, like she said to Bjorn, she needs also to accept that. To be the queen of Kattegat and to stay right there, to continue his legacy in a way. And also for herself, if she's not accepting, maybe Harald is not gonna kill her, but she wouldn't have any place on Kattegat anymore. Here, I can understand that. Even if I hate that, I can understand that. Ube, that's Groenland, you know? Greenland is all now Groenland. Okay? Which makes sense, I mean, for how it looks, but also the fact that we have to leave it and this is not the Golden Land. So he's gonna leave that land, he's gonna follow the dead, the voices of the dead, something like that, he said the scene. Ube was thinking of Ragnar, I was thinking of Loki. Because I didn't lose that hope, you know, to maybe one day having Loki back. But he has to leave that place, and even more because that place is gonna be another Iceland, I mean for them, you know, for the fact that they can't live together on a land with no resources, nothing that can help them, and even more with people like that who are fighting against each other, and even more with a well coming like that which can give them food and fuel, and someone like the snake who is claiming that the world is and no one else. I hate everything about that, you know. It really reminds me Iceland and all of the difficulties that they had at the beginning, and I hated that, really, that moment. I thought that it was painful to watch and nothing great came from that. So I hate that we have to deal with that again, to discover our land which is not giving us anything, which is only bringing us fights against each other. People are gonna die because people are gonna want to have powers, to have the resources only for themselves, to survive themselves. We have to leave that land really quick. I'm not sure that everyone is gonna follow Ube, but Ube, you have to leave that land. This is not the good one, this is not the one for you, and it can only bring bad stuff. Not with a good episode. It felt like a quick one, not a lot of big important things happened during it. Like, we knew that Aragorn was gonna be crowned king. The fact that Gunhild and Ingrid accepted to be his wives, why not? The fact that Eric accepted to be his bodyguard, and the fact that they killed Skane, why not also? But for the story, for the season, for the show, that's not big, you know? That's important for the story right now, but for the globality of the show and the story, that's not so important. That's just little things, you know, little facts which are put together like that, but it's not big, you know. Ube discovering that land, that's something big. The fact that that land is not the Golden Land and that he's gonna have to leave, you know, the seal talking to him like that, that was important. But the fact that they are fighting on that land, that they are against each other, that stuff are already happening on that land, that's not a surprise. And for the Ivar and Fitzhugh part, you know, nothing happened really. They talked, but nothing happened really. That was a good episode. I appreciated it. Again, it's a good break between death episodes. I love the fact that they keep talking about Ragnar, Lagertha and Bjorn. The fact that we saw Bjorn's departures again, it's killing me, but I love that. I really appreciate that because you know how much I love these characters, how much I cried when they died. So I love the fact that we are honoring them, and even more because this is the final episode. Like, they are not there, they are not alive, but they are still there, you know. They are still talking about them and they are still influenced by them, and I appreciate that a lot. As a fan, you know, from the first season, I appreciate that we are staying a little with these characters that we loved since the beginning. Maybe we're gonna see them again? I hope. Okay, so it's all for today for you, but me, I'm gonna watch another episode this afternoon, I think. So it's all for you for today, and it's all for me for now, so bye for now. Bye.
Wait a minute, Doc. Are you telling me that you built a time machine?
Great.